कर्नाटक से जो जीएसटी और उनके टैक्स के सारे मामलात का जो देखते हैं, उम्र में बहुत छोटे हैं, अकल में बहुत बड़े हैं, कृष्णा गौड़ा जी. ही इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट आर्टिकुलेट मिनिस्टर्स इन द जीएसटी काउंसिल.
थैंक यू मनप्रीत जी. फ्रेंड्स, गुड आफ्टरनून. विदाउट रिपीटिंग वॉट मनप्रीत जी हैज़ मेड क्लियर ऑलरेडी, I'll make two broad points and then get down to some specifics. One is, when GST was introduced in the country, the perception that was conveyed and the perception that was received was that GST would contribute to 2 percentage point increase in the GDP itself. The introduction of GST itself would accelerate GDP by about 2 percentage points additionally, which means tens of thousands of crores, which means lakhs of jobs. Now, this was the narrative only 6, 7, 8 months ago, that GDP growth rate would actually increase post-introduction of GST. I'm just reminding you of the atmosphere before introduction of GST. Now, 5 months into introduction of GST, we are talking about a declining GDP growth rate. We are talking about shrinking of businesses, closure of businesses. We are talking about net job losses, not job creation. So the mismanagement of the introduction of GST, our issue is not with GST, I'm making it very clear. It's the manner in which it has been rolled out has led to, let us understand clearly, opportunity lost. Lost opportunity of tens of thousands of crores of additional business that could have been created, ease of business that could have been created, and perhaps lakhs of jobs that could have been added in the country. This is point number one. It's an opportunity lost. I'm not sure if we can recover this lost opportunity by making the changes that we are now trying to make. I'm not sure if we can make good the lost ground or a lost opportunity. It was a historic opportunity. I'm not sure. Number two, now it is being said that Congress members were part of the council and hence Congress has to take blame as well for what is going on. I also want to remind you, because we sometimes tend to have short memory or selective amnesia, that the same situation 5, 6, 7 months ago, as if Congress had no role in rolling out of GST, as if Modi Sarkar alone was responsible for the introduction of GST in the country. I'm just reminding you. When leaving aside the historical foundation laid by the Congress party for introduction of GST, the long process of consensus building in the country, leaving aside the opposition that came from BJP ruled states earlier, and ignoring the contribution of Congress altogether, it was claimed as if Modi Sarkar alone introduced GST in the country. I'm just reminding you of that, of the changed narrative. So if Modi Sarkar was responsible for introduction of GST single-handedly, I pose a question to you, should they not also take responsibility for what follows from it? Nevertheless, that is not the line I want to push now. because it's not about who is responsible for the mess. It's about how do we get the country out of the mess that prevails, and Congress is willing to work towards that. Let me make it very clear. Earlier, we raised several issues. You might ask immediately, what were you doing? We have been raising several issues. Oftentimes, due to the overwhelming majority that prevails, a lot of our concerns were overruled. But we are now at least happy that the atmosphere in the country has convinced the government of India to have an open mind to bring about the necessary changes to come out of this mess. Now, I'll quickly mention a few because you might want to know what is it that you have talked about in the council. So I just want to quickly run through a few points which we have been raising time and again, which earlier were not being heard and now are beginning to be heard. We talked that primarily it was about the preparedness of GST. We raised questions prior to rolling out, including Congress Party and those of us who are members of the council as well, wanted to be assured that it was adequately prepared for a rollout. And we were assured at every stage that all processes are in place. And we also raised issues about GSTN, the IT backbone, which is going to sustain the GST introduction. On both accounts, time and again, we raised issues, and every stage we were assured that they were well prepared. Now, subsequently, it turns out that neither was GSTN prepared to handle, nor procedures were very clear about how to go about complying with the tax network. So as a result, lakhs of businesses have their input tax credit stalled, running into tens of thousands of crores of blocked working capital, which is pushing them towards unviability. Their businesses are becoming unviable because they have huge amounts stuck which should have been refunded to them. We also raised that in the GST and many offline utilities, ease of complying, ease of filing returns, many parameters were not ready. We raised those issues very strongly in Hyderabad GST Council meeting. Subsequently, a group of ministers was set up to handle GSTN issues. And I want to repeat, those concerns were raised by Congress Party members in the GSTN Council that led to the formation of group of ministers, which is now, though slowly, but still nevertheless methodically trying to resolve network issues, the IT issues that are plaguing compliance issues. We repeatedly raised the issues of textile sector. Even last time, Manpreet ji, myself, along with Randeep ji, met you here and spoke specifically about textile sector, how it was having a crippling effect. We went from here straight to Hyderabad Council meeting and we raised those issues. We asked that the input tax credit that was blocked off the textile sector, which was pushing them out of business, that should be unlocked. And we demanded that small and medium enterprises should be given a quarterly filing return instead of a monthly return. And both of these were agreed in the last meeting. So time and we were raising these issues earlier, but the receptivity to resolve those issues was on a lower side, and now Government of India is agreeing to many of these and are trying to resolve. We have raised about agriculture sector, agriculture inputs at a higher rate. For example, micro irrigation components being at 18%, some of them at an even higher rate. This is burdening the farm sector. Tractor parts, which were at 28%. And issues related to silk also. So we have been repeatedly raising these issues. Even textile, something outside GST that is affecting the sector is the lowering of the import duty on many of the yarn and such imports, which we in the council are not responsible. That is something that Government of India has lowered the import duties. countervailing duties, and hence it's making domestic textile sector uncompetitive. We have also been raising about construction material, many of which are at 28%. Now, yes, the big builders, they get refund of the taxes paid, but many individuals who build their homes have to buy construction material at 28%, and they don't get a paisa refund of the taxes that pay. For example, everything, cement, bricks, many paints, plumbing equipment, many of them are at 28%. So this has increased housing cost as well. And we have been asking that many of these should be shifted from 28 to 18%. And we are going to press for that in the upcoming meeting as well. We have been repeatedly raising issues related to restaurant sector in the country, that it should be treated with a lighter hand, and that we should not go by some, you know, strictly by the past precedents, that we should have a lighter approach towards the sector. We have been repeatedly asking that the non-air conditioned portion of the restaurants, which are even in, you know, there may be one portion which is air conditioned, if there is a non-air conditioned portion, that is getting taxed at 18%, when we have been asking that it should be lowered to 12% or something like that. And we hope, we are going to press for this again, that restaurants which are at 18% should come down to 12%. Another big sector is tourism. Today, in fact, in the country, if one sector has got the potential to generate a lot of jobs, that is tourism. A lot of the tourism operations are at 28%. We have been asking that it should be brought down to, Honorable Chief Minister from Puducherry has been consistently asking that the tourism sector should be at a lower tax rate of 18% or less. I, from Karnataka, have been raising about branded agriculture commodities like pulses. If the moment it gets branded, it attracts a 5% tax. We have been saying that these are primary commodities and they should be exempted. So these are just some examples that we have been pushing for earlier. Many of our demands were overlooked. I hope now Government of India has realized that these are having real consequences on the ground, that these are affecting people badly. At least that backlash from the society, I hope, will force Government of India to take these constructive suggestions as constructive suggestions, not something to be brushed aside and move forward just because there is a majority that they can do it. I hope these we will take up all these issues. I just listed a few so as to give you a flavor of what the issues are, but there are many more issues which we would be hoping. One opportunity, you know, if you look at the, just before concluding, again, a broad statement, the first month of filings had about 56 lakh taxpayers. Second month, it came down to 52 lakhs. In the third month, I think it has come down to about 48 lakhs. So the idea of GST was to actually broad-base the tax broaden the tax base, bring more people in. But the last 3 months, because of the hard-fisted nature in which we have approached, because of lack of preparedness on the IT side, because of lack of clarity on many rules and procedures, in the 3 months, the taxpayer base has actually come down. We need to reverse this. We need to treat MSME, the biggest job creators in the country, with a lighter touch, and Congress Party will continue to take up their issues, and in the Guwahati meeting as well, we will push hard to flag these issues and get some of the reliefs that people around the country are expecting, and Congress Party will try to do that job diligently.